It is a female driver, correct?
Oh, it looks to be slowing down a little bit. Okay.
Yeah, it looks like she's slowing down. Maybe it looked like maybe some a tire piece or something like that came off, and now we're hearing
I think she just ran over that. I don't think that came off.
That may be the case. Yeah, 91 East at Green River.
Okay, watch this. All right, now where, I wonder if we can pan out a little bit. Yeah, get a little bit of perspective.
91 eastbound at Anaheim Hills. I have to mention, too, seldom do we see, it's rare to see a female driver behind the wheel of a high-speed chase.
Here we go now. Let's see.
Slowing down, and now starting right back up again.
This is interesting.
The stop and starts.
This female driver has done a couple of fake outs to the police officers. When she approached the interchange at the 55 freeway, it looked like she was going to go
south.
Looks like
she's trying to decide. Okay.
Oh.
Back on.
This is a brazen driver for sure. So she was faking out the CHP that she was going to get off the freeway, that she was going to go south. Instead, at the last moment, she took the 55 north and faked them out.
Each individual's circumstances are different, but you're right. They do. Some individuals, at a certain point, they just kind of throw caution to the wind and say, I'm just going to do whatever and keep this going as long as I can.
Here she goes over the medium.
Over to the side.
Oh, maybe she's pulling over.
Not sure what she's going to.
Oh, Ginger, my goodness. She's going to come to the other side and flip it around if she can. That would be my guess. Or maybe, I think she's trying to fake out some of the officers. Maybe running low on gas and trying to slosh some unbelievable brazen driver. Damage already.
She's heading the wrong way.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that. Completely faked out the CHP officers.
Look at the bumper.
This could be such a hazardous situation now.
She's going the wrong way. Traveling, let's just make sure everybody knows this location right here. 241.
She can't traverse up that hill. Okay, now she's turning back around again, obviously realizing there was nowhere for her to go.
Unbelievable.
Now there are so many cars.
This is the 241 South approaching Rancho Santa Margarita. She's doing it again.
She's trying to get. I bet she was trying to get enough speed to get up that hill.
She's trying to get to the north side.
Now, officer, now that she's really driving.
Oh my gosh! Now she's going back
erratically
down.
Like this. Do you think they'll pull a pit maneuver or something?
Yes. At this point in time, she's exhibited that she really does not have much thought for the safety of others on the road,
and
so they may do that.
Anything like this.
Unbelievable. Well, this is just, it's her going into panic mode at this point, too. She doesn't know what to do. Is she headed in the wrong direction again, Ginger Chan?
No, she's back in the right direction.
Okay,
this is the correct direction.
And again, turning around to head back up this hill.
She really just doesn't know what to do, is what it looks like. Yeah.
I think she's playing with the cameras.
All right. Do we have some officers up ahead of her? Well, now there she goes again.
And now
she
stops.
She may have run out of gas. I mean, it's
and now she's getting herself up.
Oh no!
The car's still going.
Oh, she's angry.
Wow.
She gets out to yell at police.
Here we go. Looks like they're going to pull the pit maneuver right there.
There we go.
Wow.
Her front bumper looked like there was already some damage. She's going to keep going.
And she is
angry at the officers. Look at that.
Unbelievable. She's continuing.
Continuing south on the 241, approaching Rancho Santa Margarita. And that looks like maybe
she's getting off.
Getting off, yep.
She's off the highway now.
She possibly might be doubling back around, and maybe she'll get back onto the freeway because, as Officer Montoya said, there's a good possibility that she would maybe try to go back.
These are surface streets now, so let's be very careful as we watch this.
Look at that.
That's an intersection, obviously.
Look at that right here.
There she is. She's not stopping.
41. Look at that. Now they've got her boxed in. Oh, my goodness. She's like giving up. There's no way she's getting out of that car unless they drag her out. Look at this.
And this is it.
1-2. It looks like three cars made impact there.
They were not going to even let her get close to
maybe let's see where she is. She's still in the vehicle right now. Let's watch closely here. I see at least six officers near her, but she's still in the vehicle.
And do we have any
look at that
idea?
Officer. Look at that
look
officer
at that,
on the
breaking
left.
The window
breaking
there to
the
get her out.
To get to her.
Where are we, Ginger? Do we?
Just as the 241 freeway ends, basically.
We've got one officer on top of the Scion right there. You've got officers on both sides of the car. They've obviously had to break the passenger side window to get in. They are pulling her out of the driver's window.
She does not want to get out.
Pulling her. It's taking four officers to bring her down. They're putting her down on the ground. I'm assuming she will be face down. They will cuff her at this point.
Unbelievable. Coming to a peaceful ending, though. Thank goodness.
Fortunately, because the way the speeds and the erratic driving, unfortunately, came to a peaceful.
Incredibly dramatic ending, though.
Unbelievable.
We talk about most of the times you see these, there will be one pit maneuver, a car will stop, and they'll sort of cage them in. But you saw all three of those CHP cruisers. It took all three of them to just really box her in.
Kudos.
Great job by the CHP,
officers,
though. You have to say, that was amazing.
Major kudos. Once again, let's bring folks up to date. If you just happen to be joining us at the conclusion of all of this, we joined this, about 20 minutes or so ago, this pursuit?
It's been more than a half hour.
Has it been about 30 minutes? Mm-hmm. Okay, about 6:20 or so is apparently when police got the call. This woman involved in some sort of a domestic dispute. You can take a look on the left-hand side of your screen there in the box. You can see this woman's erratic driving. She's been pretty much doing this all morning long.
And of course, that's when she was going down the wrong way of the highway. She'd stopped, she'd turned, she'd done a few donuts, she started down the wrong way, realized that wasn't such a good idea, turned back around, and then get this, she gained some speed and actually tries to make it up the hillside embankment between the two highways, the north and the south lanes. Officers are trying to follow her, but again, knowing not where she's going, it's amazing that the officers really didn't run into each other in all of this, going in so many different directions.
Really, they did such a phenomenal job.
She turns around. This was fascinating here. She gets back again. Now, here's an opportunity to start going the southbound lane. She could have just started speeding, but no, she turns back down, and I found this to be so interesting. Goes back down to where it all started. And of course, officers then shortly
looks
after
like
this.
Looks she's arguing with the female officer like, there.
Yeah, she just.
Yeah.
You would usually see them just put her into the
now,
vehicle.
We're trying to put her into the vehicle right now, and she's not.
She's verbally,
being quiet about this, is she?
Yeah, she's definitely wants to be heard. And also, you could see that. Look at this. We have sheriffs here. We also have highway patrol, and then we know the Long Beach police officers were also pursuing her. And so we also had heard earlier from Officer Montoya that she was possibly trying to assault an officer with her vehicle. So this was definitely a dangerous suspect. And look at this with all the different agencies that responded to this. This may be the reason we have this peaceful and quiet ending in terms of. Like no other people being hurt in this situation here with this pursuit.